All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is Dr. Kazi back with another video. In this video, we are going to learn about the difference between the false pelvis and the true pelvis. But before discussing that, let us revise what we already know about the pelvis. Have a look at this diagram. Os coxae, also known as the hip bone, is formed by the fusion of three bones, the ilium, ischium, and the pubis. Now, this is the lateral side of the hip bone, and how do we know that this is the lateral side? By looking at this fossa right here, which is known as the acetabulum fossa. This fossa will form the hip joint with the head of the femur. Now, this is the lateral side, and if I turn this lateral side like this, we get the medial side of the hip bone. The medial side is divided by this line, which I have shown with the white color, into two parts. This line will divide the medial side into two parts. The above is iliac fossa, and beneath this arcuate line, we have the flat surface, which will continue with the flat surface of these two bones, the pubic and the ischium bones. Okay? The iliac fossa is a depression which will contain the iliacus muscle. Now, the arcuate line will continue down into this red line, which is known as the pectineal line. These two lines together, arcuate line plus the pectineal line, will form iliopectineal line. Now, this is really important. Iliopectineal line, because it will divide the whole pelvis into two parts. The upper one is known as the false pelvis, and the lower one is known as the true pelvis. Now, this is the medial side of one hip bone, and this is the medial side of the other hip bone. And if we join these two hip bones together, we form a structure something like this. Looks like a butterfly. We obtain the whole pelvis cavity. Now, the hip joint is forming, the hip bone is forming two types of joint, the sacroiliac joint and the symphysis pubis. Now, the sacroiliac joint is the joint between the sacrum and the ilium of the hip bone, and the symphysis pubis is the joint between the two pubic bones. Okay? Now, if we trace the iliopectineal line of one hip bone to the other hip bone, we obtain some structure like this. Now, this dotted red line represents pelvic brim, also called as the pelvic inlet. It is a demarcation of the true pelvis and the false pelvis. In other words, this red dotted line will divide the pelvis into two parts. Let's compare this whole pelvis with this cylindrical structure in order to understand it more clearly. This red dotted line represents iliopectineal line of the two hip bones, which will form the pelvic brim or the pelvic inlet. Now, above the pelvic inlet, we have false pelvis. Have a look. Above the pelvic inlet, we have false pelvis. And below this pelvic inlet or the pelvic brim, we have the true pelvis. False pelvis, also known as the greater pelvis, and the true pelvis, also known as the lesser pelvis. Now, let's understand it more clearly by looking at the boundaries of the false pelvis as well as true pelvis. We will see what is in front of the false pelvis, what is on the lateral side, and what is behind it. So, in front of the false pelvis, or anteriorly, we have the anterior abdominal wall, because the anterior abdominal wall continues down into the false pelvis, and false pelvis is considered as the part of the abdomen. On the lateral side of the false pelvis, we have the iliac fossa, which contain the iliacus muscle. And behind or posteriorly of the false pelvis, we have lumbar vertebra. Let us see what is in front, anterior, lateral, and posterior to the true pelvis. Very simple to remember. In front of it, we see we have the symphysis pubis. On the lateral side, we have the iliopectineal lines. And posteriorly, we have sacral promontory. Now, what is sacral promontory? We know that this whole sacrum bone is formed by the fusion of five rudimentary sacral vertebra. Now, first sacral vertebra, the anterior portion of this first sacral vertebra bulges forward to form sacral promontory, which is the posterior boundary of true pelvis. Now, the question is, what is the importance of the false pelvis and the true pelvis? Remember, false pelvis do not have much clinical importance. After the third month of pregnancy, false pelvis supports the growing uterus. And the false pelvis continues down into the true pelvis. But true pelvis is really important because it forms a bony canal through which the baby will be born. Okay, this is all about the anatomy of the pelvis, and I will see you in the next video. Like, share, and subscribe. Goodbye.